welcome to Simplifi TV. I'm David McBee. Our guest today is Samantha Bedford, founder and CEO of Pico Digital Marketing. Samantha is an award-winning digital expert who provides SMEs and B2B marketers with sophisticated web analytics and data analysis expertise to coordinate effective, trustworthy marketing and sales actions throughout the B2B customer journey. Samantha's ability to integrate customer experience across every department of an SME stems from extensive knowledge with SEO, PPC, lead generation, customer experience, and conversion rate optimization. Samantha relies on a tried and tested methodology perfected throughout her award-winning career in media planning, search engine marketing, and social media spanning more than 25 years. Samantha, welcome to Simplifi TV.
Thanks so much for having me.
It's always fun to hear your bio read by someone else, isn't it? It makes you feel special.
I know. I'm sort of like sitting here and I'm like, wow.
I'm kind of a big deal, right?
Yes.
Well, I want to just jump right into your expertise. I know that you have worked with big agencies in your career, and now you're more of a boutique agency. So you've had that breadth of experience across, you know, small to large. So what do you think is the biggest issue that's facing marketing agencies of all sizes in 2023?
Ooh, I think it's everywhere at the moment, not just agencies, but obviously, you know, AI, you know, is a pretty big deal out there. And I think being ready for it, being set up for it, and being adaptive to it, and changing the historical ways of how we've done things.
Dive into that a little bit. What are you doing that's different or unique?
I guess the biggest thing is just looking at how AI can sort of improve our use of time, right? And enable us to actually use our time a lot more strategically instead of doing, you know, using the time for like grunt work, right? You know, and how can we use AI to improve that? You know, I think a lot of what, you know, I'm investing my time in right now is looking at, you know, prompt engineers and, you know, like all of these different prompts that you can use in like ChatGPT, for example, you know, that can say you've written a responsive search ad, right? And you're sitting there and you're like, oh, gosh, you know, 15 headlines. Poof, that's a lot. You know, and using, you know, ChatGPT to sort of guide some of the opportunity, you know, guide some of like maybe the final 10, you know, you give them five, they maybe spit out another 10 and, you know, help you get to that 15 number, you know, and just sort of putting, it's enabling us to sort of like test faster and learn quicker. And that's sort of what I'm enjoying there. I think the big challenge though is, you know, with all of this is essentially the silos that exist. You know, obviously in smaller boutique agencies, there's not as many silos as large agencies. But, you know, with AI and, you know, machine learning, all of it, those silos, if there is silos within your agency, the problem you're going to have is that you're going to have your marketing team right out there, you know, designing campaigns for search, social, et cetera, you know, and then you've got your design team over here, you know, and if they don't communicate properly, you know, you're not going to win at, you know, win at this game. And also the speed to delivery as well. You know, I think, you have to be quick. You have to be on it and you have to have a good testing strategy. And when I think the other piece of it, obviously with it being automated, the large piece is going back to those basics and making sure that what you want to track is being tracked. So really analyzing that customer journey and pinpointing these are the things that I want to track. But from an algorithm standpoint, you know, so smart bidding in Google, for example, or Meta, you know, if you want to implement any of that algorithmic smart bidding, it needs to make sure that it's optimizing to the right conversion or conversions. And I think, you know, in the past, we've been so, oh, you know, we'll track a phone call. You know, it doesn't mean that that phone call is a sale or, you know, generated any revenue. It could just be a support call. But in the past, you know, we would be okay with the algorithms optimizing to something like that. But now that it's everything is becoming so much more automated, you know, and more driven by what you put into the system, it's more important today to make sure that you go back to those basics and be like, right, this is the only primary conversion event that I want, you know, AI to function on.
So you're speaking from the point of view of a boutique agency owner. Let's assume that I am a brand and I am torn between going with a boutique like yours or a large brand. And I say, well, they've got so many more people on their staff. They've got so much more expertise. They've got a wide breadth of knowledge. What is your take on that thought process that leads brands to the bigger agencies?
Yeah, I think, you know, bigger agencies obviously have a lot more people, right? So that's the big difference. It's just the people. It's not the skills. If anything, you know, you will find those smaller boutique agencies are a lot more passionate about their clients because they're smaller, right? I mean, you know, the only way we're going to make money is, you know, keeping our clients happy. And, you know, that's it. Like, there is no other options, you know, and everyone's a lot more invested in the success of the clients and the companies. You know, larger agencies, for example, I mean, a lot of their staff, I mean, they're there for a payslip, right? You know, they're not, I wouldn't say they're not invested in their clients. I'm sure, you know, they've gone into these careers being passionate about the career. So at least I'm hopeful with that. You know, and I've met a lot of great people in large agencies, but I also find a lot of large agencies miss the, you know, the bigger you are, the more red tape, the more silos there are, the slower the processes can be because you've got to slot in. And, you know, if you're not their biggest client, even if you're a large client, you know, you might not be their largest client. Love your tattoo, by the way. Be awesome. To be awesome, exactly, to commit to be awesome for the clients, then we have to be upfront with them straight away. We have to be transparent. And if this client's going to take a lot more hours than we can push to them, then we're not going to be the right agency for them. Even if we know we can maybe do a better job, it's just not the right thing to do. It's all about time. If we don't have the time, we won't take on the client.
All right. So before we go, I like to ask all my guests, do you have a favorite podcast or a book that you feel has helped you become successful?
The biggest things that I always go to is just obviously search engine land. I eat, sleep and breathe it. You know, I'm on it all the time. I don't know if anybody's attended it, but SMX Advanced is amazing. Some great materials there.
If our viewers want to reach out to you, how can they do that?
Yeah, so I'm on LinkedIn. So you can just, you know, find me on LinkedIn, obviously. So Samantha Bedford. And they can also obviously take a look at my website. So it's choosepico.com. And then obviously feel free to, you know, send me a message, email me. It's sam@choosepico.com. And I would, you know, love to connect with you. And even if you've just got any questions in general, I've been doing this for 25 years and I'm happy to help out anybody. So
that's very nice of you. Thank you so much. Thank you for being on my show today. I appreciate you.
Yes. Thanks for having me. It was good chatting with you.
And thank you guys for watching. Simplifi TV is sponsored by Simplifi, helping you to maximize relevance and multiply results with our industry-leading media buying and workflow solutions. For more information, visit simpli.fi. Thanks for joining us today. I'm David McBee. Be awesome, and we'll see you next time.